In this video, I'm going to talk about our real estate market here in the Greater Toronto Area. I'm shooting this video February 20th, 2020, and we'll cover the stats. Firstly, let's address and compare January 2020 to January 2019. As we look at the stats, the most interesting thing is the change in average price. This is really positive for sellers. The average price is up by 12% year over year. In January 2019, it was $747,000, whereas in January 2020, the average price was $839,000. Likely, what could have led to this very large increase is the fact that the active listings are still very low. As you look around in most areas, there's not a lot of homes up for sale. Or if you're in a condominium, there's not a lot of units up for sale. And as shown by this stat, again, in January 2019, there was just about 12,000 active listings, whereas in January 2020, there was only 7,700. Again, that's a 35% decrease in active listings. So naturally, this is going to lead to a greater price. Our average days on market is a lot less, and the increase in price is a lot more balanced, meaning we're seeing an increase in price for detached homes, for townhouses, for semi-detached homes, and for condominium apartments, whereas the market that we've been exposed to over the past couple years has more so been favorable for condos. So as condos appreciated, where detached homes either slightly increased, slightly decreased, or just stayed stable. But what so is, it is still the case that condo apartments have gone up the most in price. They're up by 15% year over year. Right now, our average price condominium is selling at $630,000. Although, fortunately for detached homeowners, the average price of a detached home is up by 10.5%, now sitting at $1,038,247. If you were to ask me what are some of the hottest areas right now, it seems to be Toronto, specifically the East End, where you have those lower priced homes, a little bit older homes, typical like three bedroom bungalow with a basement apartment. These properties are selling in an average of 14 days, whereas on the slower side, it's the York Region detached home, specifically in Richmond Hill or in Markham. If you have a property which is priced over $2 million, then do find the best agent possible, because those are a little bit more challenging. Their days on market is obviously a lot higher. The worst market seems to be King City, as the average days on market in King is 95 days. That's over 3 months. Can you imagine? Wow. Otherwise, if you have a property that's priced less than 1.2 million, or if it's in Toronto, somewhere around the average price threshold, then you'll likely get a bidding war on your property. It's been my experience that the past two properties I've put on the market have gotten multiple offers. A property I listed last week had 10 offers in 4 days. This is the type of market where you want to be in the best hands. Hire the most skilled professional agent to get your home sold, to represent your interests, and to negotiate the best possible price on your home. If you're considering selling in the next short while or buying, call me. My number is 416-671-5218. It's Michael Dougal with RE/MAX Premier. And again, the market is very strong. We're already in the spring. It's the early spring. And believe me, this is the best market we've had over the past 18 months by far. I'll look forward to seeing you all next time.